With the arrival of COVID-19 in India, one of the many discussions that started was its spread through the air conditioning systems, as the summer season was approaching with temperatures soaring in March itself. Not thinking much, people started hitting onto Google search to understand the relation between COVID-19 and air conditioner, as we do it most of the time. And we came across many articles on the same, with some giving awareness and some only to bring more fear in our lives. For any virus to spread, you need a carrier of the virus near you. Just the same way for COVID-19 to spread, if you're near to the infected person, that is the carrier of virus, without your mask and strong immune system, then you have a high possibility of getting infected, which we all possibly know by now. But the question that arises here is, does the air conditioner spread the virus? Hi, I'm Prateek Malik. By education, I'm an engineer and a PGDBA in marketing. I have 16 years of experience in training domain with various multinational companies in consumer electronics and home appliances. The purpose of this video is to get you to know on how an air conditioner works, so that you can evaluate if the air conditioner spread the virus or not. Before we move on to know how an air conditioner works, let's understand what does an air conditioner do, because for most of us, it is just an appliance which does the cooling. So let's understand what exactly it is capable of doing. Going by the definition, an air conditioner can be defined as an equipment which controls the following to maintain comfortable conditions. So the first one is air temperature. Whether your air conditioner is with remote or with thermostat knob, you can control the desired temperature in the room for cooling. And if you have a hot and cold air conditioner, you can have the comfort in all the seasons. Second is air humidity. So for many of the people who move from an air cooler to the air conditioner, it is one of the key aspects. I'm sure that if you are a user of an air conditioner, you would surely have seen the drain pipe in case of split and nozzle at the back of the window AC. That is where it drains out the excessive moisture or humidity from the room to maintain the optimum levels to keep you comfortable. Third is airflow. We feel air only when it touches our skin, and unlike window air conditioner, which throws air only in a particular direction of the louver or duct, the split air conditioner advanced models from different brands come with the options of comfort air, which gives a breeze-like feel. Fourth one is air purity. As the air conditioner operates on the principle of rotating the room air, so the filter on the cooling coils, or the coils which are in the inside of the room, it not only protects the coils and increases the life of the air conditioner, but also cleans the room air depending on the filter. And one such filter is odor filter, which is controlling the odor in the room air, and this feature depends on which variant of the air conditioner you have bought, as you have to shell out extra money to have advanced filters in your air conditioner. So to summarize, what does an air conditioner do? In all, air conditioner is an equipment which helps in controlling air temperature, air humidity, air flow, air purity, and air odor. Now, let us understand the working of the air conditioner. Although there are many components in an air conditioner, but to keep the thing simple, we will understand about the five key components with respect to cooling type split air conditioner. First is evaporator coils, or the cooling coils. Second is condenser coils, or the heat dissipator coils. Third is the heart of air conditioning system, that is the compressor. Fourth is the expansion valve, which includes the capillary tube as well. Fifth is the fan motor. In case of split air conditioner, the evaporator coils are in the indoor unit. The other components are in the outdoor unit. Thus, the five key components are useless if the refrigerant, or in layman's language, gas, is not there in the air conditioning system. A refrigerant is a compound used in heat cycle that undergoes a phase change from a vapor to a liquid and back. Various refrigerants that you may have heard from the salesperson or service technician's mouth are: R22 is a non-CFC free refrigerant, which means if it leaks into the air, it can have a ozone depletion effect. Hence, many brands have shifted to cleaner refrigerants like R410A and R32 to save the planet Earth. R32 is more eco-friendly and have lower global warming potential than R410A. Let's understand in the next slide on how and where this refrigerant phase changes and how cooling happens. Although the cycle starts from the heart of air conditioning system, that is the compressor. However, for ease of understanding, we will start it from the evaporator coils. So the refrigerant enters into the evaporator coil in liquid form at temperature close to 4 degrees Celsius. And when the room air, which is warm, touches the evaporator coils, the heat from the room air, I repeat, the heat from the room air gets transferred into the refrigerant, and cold air comes into the room because the blower is just rotating the air. Now, because of the heat transfer into the refrigerant, it changes its phase from liquid to vapor and goes into the compressor. The compressor compresses it and the refrigerant comes out at high pressure and temperature. And it moves into the condenser coils where a fan is placed, which throws outside air only onto condenser coils, helping in removing heat from refrigerant by making the refrigerant flow through various levels. It is just like pouring hot tea into a saucer, so that it can easily remove the heat. The condenser coil condenses the vapor phase of the refrigerant into liquid phase, but it is still hot when it enters the expansion valve. The expansion valve filters off any impurity from the refrigerant, and when this hot refrigerant passes through capillary tube, it becomes really cold due to the application of the Joule-Thomson effect. I repeat, Joule-Thomson effect, which says when refrigerant moves from high pressure zone to low pressure zone, the temperature reduces. Well, you might have experienced this effect while bathing as well. When you use shower instead of tap, the water from the shower is colder than from the tap. And this whole cycle keeps on running till the time compressor is on. You may go back to beginning of the slide to understand the process better, because it is not easy to remember it at one go. Now, after knowing the working of air conditioner, you must have got that none of the components can bring coronavirus into the room, unless there is an infected person already present in the room. There could be a few brands in the market which may claim that their air conditioner can filter off coronavirus, but believe me, there is no better safety measure than the face masks and social distancing, because the virus can reach you first before the air conditioner pulls the room air for filtration. Before you stop the video here thinking that it is over, it is important to take a look at the type of air conditioners we use for domestic purpose. The window air conditioners, as the name suggests, are put on the window area of the room. These are generally well sealed for the rotation of room air, so it pulls the room air, filters it, and sends the cool air from the outlet. In some of the window air conditioners, there is an option of fresh air intake, which certainly helps in mixing of fresh air and keeps you away from suffocation. However, if an infected person is outside and the fresh air intake is active, it may also get the virus inside the room. Well, in homes, it may not be such a situation, as the fresh air is pulled from either the balcony or open spaces, and that make the chances of the virus spread to almost negligible. And nobody with a window air conditioner installed in the shaft would want to have a fresh air intake model. So, if the window air conditioners are installed in the medical institutions, one need to exercise more caution. Although window air conditioners are pretty much in demand even these days, but is being replaced by the split air conditioners due to the single window in most of the newly constructed houses, and people really don't want to choke up that particular space. And of course, there are many other advantages of split air conditioners. Some of the advantages of split over the window air conditioner are, the first one, of course, no obstruction of the window space. Second, quiet operation, as the noise making heart of the air conditioner, that is the compressor, is in the outdoor unit. Good air distribution due to wide inflow and outflow of room air. Better energy efficiency as compared to window air conditioner for the same star rating. Don't forget to check for ISEER on the BEE label if you wish to go in for a more energy efficient air conditioner. With respect to the prevailing COVID-19 situation, there is something good that we have in the split air conditioner, that is, in most of the brands, it does not have a fresh air intake option, which makes it safe from spreading the virus from outside. We can categorize a split air conditioner as safe, quiet, and efficient. Another type of split is cassette air conditioner. It is installed in the false ceiling and hence keeps your walls clean and the cooling is faster. It has all the same benefits as that of a wall type split air conditioner as discussed previously. However, there are few brands with limited models which come with the fresh air intake option. Well, this was about the domestic air conditioners. But does malls, hotels, restaurants, hospitals, airports, offices, and many more places, do they use domestic air conditioners? Well, some of them may. Most of them have central air conditioning system, where one or multiple big outdoor units are there based on the heat load and area coverage. The volume of air what they circulate per minute is certainly much higher than the domestic ones, and so to manage air purity level, they have big filters, and basis the application, some also use HEPA, that is the high efficiency particulate air filters. Although necessary measures have been taken at these places with use of most effective filtration process for your safety. But nothing beats COVID-19 better than practicing social distancing, and always wear a face mask and carry sanitizer when you move out of your home. I hope this video would have given you the required information to analyze whether air conditioner spreads the virus or not. Stay safe. If you wish to see this video with Hindi audio, please leave your comments in the box below. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel for updates on products and the technology, corporate learnings, and soft skills. Thank you.